What a lovely old pipe.
It was bought by my mother secondhand in 1937, so she could go use it to Oxford University, where she just qualified to go to. Used it for commuting around Oxford before the war. And then she was called up to be one of the codebreakers at Bletchley Park.
Oh, really?
Bletchley Park was the top secret home of the codebreakers, employed to crack enemy communications in World War II. Hugh's mum, Rachel, played a vital role in the war effort.
She was seconded to Hut 6, which was one of the main code-breaking rooms at Bletchley Park, and went there with the bike that we've got here today. And then at Bletchley Park, she met my father, who was another of the code-breakers. Their eyes met, obviously, over the code room. I don't know the history of it, but presumably that is what happened. And a romance started, and they got married whilst they were stationed there.
Hugh's father, Michael, helped to identify weaknesses in coded messages. It's estimated the codebreakers shortened the war by 2 years, and in doing so, saved over 14 million lives.
So this is quite important to the war effort, in a way, if it was transporting a mother to Bletchley Park.
I suppose you could say that.
And what's your very earliest memory of this bike?
It had a wee saddle on here that I used to sit on, and I used to hold the handlebars while she was pedalling.
It's got great sentimental value.
Indeed, yes. She is now 99.
Okay. Right, wow.
And still living in the same house that I was brought up in.
When did she last ride the bike?
From my knowledge, 1983.
So has it been off the road since then?
It's been off the road almost since then.
Okay, so what would you like me to do to the bike?
Well, I think if you look at it, there's a few things that are glaringly obvious. The rear brake.
Yes, absolutely.
The rod is actually fractured where it goes in there.
We can repair
and connects
that
to the back. The other major aspect, I think, is the drive chain.
Okay. I can see that's got stretching.
It's very, very, very worn and rusty. And the rear sprocket, the teeth are have become that hook shape, so need somehow restoring.
Is your mother looking forward to seeing it restored?
She is really looking forward to seeing it, yes, because she's got a great deal of sentimental attachment to it. It's been with her all her life.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Lovely to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right. Bye-bye now.
Cheers. To have the bike restored is really, really important to me. It's been in the family for so long, and really it's like an old friend, and it will give me and the rest of the family a great feeling of pleasure to see it restored.
The bike was manufactured by the Birmingham Small Arms Company, founded in 1861. They produced high-quality metal goods, from military and sporting firearms to cars, bikes and buses.
I can see already that there's a few things that are broken, that are worn out, that need replacing. For instance, the handlebars, obviously that rear brake linkage is broken, so that needs replacing. The saddle here, that's a little bit too far gone, and I think we need to try and find a replacement of some sort. Also, the rear hub, it's basically worn out. But other than that, it's got its original paintwork. It just wants a good clean and a good overhaul.
How you doing, Tim?
Hello.
Got some tyres for you.
Oh, perfect timing. Fantastic. Yeah, I'm just about to take this one off. I think it should come out all right. It's in really good order.
You see, I love it when you say it's all right. To me, this bike doesn't look all right. It looks far from it.
Well, it looks a bit of a wreck at the moment, but actually, it's pretty straight. The wheels are true. It just needs a bit of love and care. That's all it needs.
Okay, yeah. Cool. So I'm going to leave you with these.
Okay, brilliant.
And I just can't wait to see it when it's finished.
Okay.
Making his own discoveries out in the metal workshop, restorer Tim is getting down to the nuts and bolts of the BSA bike.
I can see now that the chain itself is so badly worn. It's probably original to the bike, and I'd like to keep it, but it's too far gone, and I just have to replace it because it will make the bike safer and it will make everything work properly. This rear sprocket is so badly worn that it's worn away the teeth, and it gives this characteristic hooked effect. So basically that's got to be replaced. Obviously Hugh's mum pedalled backwards and forwards to Bletchley Park, and that's probably where the mileage went in.
With worn teeth, the sprocket can't bite on the bike chain, meaning the rear wheel won't be powered.
So what I've got to do now is I've got to remove this sprocket from this housing here, which is easier said than done. The heat, all that does is expands the joint in the threads. Obviously, there's a lot of old residue and oil and bits and pieces which is burning, which is what you can see there. You see it's starting to go a little bit of a cherry red colour.
Using a tool called a chain whip, Tim releases the old sprocket from the hub.
There we go. Perfect. I've managed to source a replacement sprocket of the same type that was originally fitted. This has come out of my stores, and as you can see as a comparison now, you can see the difference. There we go. That's the hub repaired. It just needs, to carry on cleaning it.
With a long road of repairing ahead of him, Tim needs to enlist the services of metal worker Dom Chenier.
Hello, Dom.
Hey, Tim, you okay?
I wonder if you can help me. I've just taken the mud guards off of Hugh's bike.
Okay.
And I've noticed that they've got a couple of little splits in.
Oh, God, okay.
That need a little bit of repair, and I'm hoping that you can help out. The only thing I'm worried about is that that's the original transfer for the bike.
Oh,
there's
yeah.
a little split there that might cause a little bit of an issue.
It's very close,
so
yeah, obviously.
I'd like to try and preserve these if I can.
Yeah, OK. I'll give it my best shot.
All right. I'll try and leave them with you.
Careful as I can. Yeah, OK. Thanks, Tim.
Thanks very much.
With Dom repairing the cracked mud guards, Tim can turn his attention to the brakes.
This brake rod here is broken. What I've got to do is I've got to undo that nut, and then I've got to try and pull that broken rod out inside there, and then I'm going to weld it to the end. It's quite easy just to replace that with a brand new one. But this bike's been through World War II, and I'd like to put that original piece back together again. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I'm really pleased with that. That's gone better than I hoped. So that should be ready to go back in the bike again.
There you go, Tim. These are ready for you now.
Oh, OK, Dom, thanks very much.
That's the one that was the dangerous one near the transfer.
Yeah, that's a crucial one, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That's come out all well. Brilliant job. Thanks, Dom.
Good, no problem.
Cheers.
Thanks, Tim.
Are you excited?
I am very excited, and looks roughly the same shape under there.
Yeah.
Let's put him out of his
misery. Go on then, Jay. Take it off.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Absolutely beautiful. Sorry, I feel quite emotional about seeing it. It's really, yeah.
Yeah, I can understand that.
So the only thing that's left to do, really, with something like this, is to test it.
Absolutely.
To see how it goes.
Yes.
So would you do us the honour?
Of course I would.
So how was that then?
That was really good fun.
Yeah?
Brought back a lot of memories.
Excellent. I'm really pleased you like it.
It's lovely. Fabulous job.
It's been a real pleasure.
He's done a good job, man.
He has.
Yeah.
So we don't need to wrap it up now, do we?
No, I'm cycling home now.
You are?
Yeah, it's only 600 miles.
Right, it's that way.
OK. Are you sure it's that way?
Yeah,
I don't
want
to go the wrong way.
Yeah, I think it is that way.
Bye.
Take care now.
It felt fabulous riding the bike and very comfortable, surprisingly. I'm going to take the bicycle to my mother's house, and I think she'll be absolutely delighted. It does bring back very happy memories.